Very good morning, students. Previous session, we discussed what is sexually transmitted disease, and also we discussed one of the sexually transmitted disease, AIDS. Symptoms, preventive measures, transmission. Now, we are going to discuss sexually transmitted disease caused by bacteria and viruses. Let me see, hepatitis B or serum hepatitis. Hepatitis B or serum hepatitis. So what is hepatitis B or serum hepatitis? It is one of the sexually transmitted disease. It is a serious liver infection caused by hepatitis B virus, that is HBV. This is the causal organism for hepatitis B or serum hepatitis. For some people, hepatitis B infection becomes chronic, that means it lasts for more than 6 months. Having chronic hepatitis B increases the risk of developing liver failure, liver cancer, or cirrhosis. So what is cirrhosis? A condition that permanently scars of the liver. Infants and children are more likely to develop a chronic hepatitis B infection. So it is one of the sexually transmitted disease. This hepatitis B or serum hepatitis caused by a virus, hepatitis B virus. Let me see what are the symptoms of hepatitis B or serum hepatitis. Symptoms of hepatitis B. Signs and symptoms of hepatitis B range from mild to severe. They usually appear about 1 to 4 months after you have been infected, although you could see the symptoms as early as 2 weeks post infection. Some people, usually young children, may not have any symptoms. So what are all the symptoms? The symptoms may include abdominal pain, fever, loss of appetite, nausea, vomiting, yellowness of eyes and skin, light colored stools, itching of skin, headache, joint pain, dark urine, and fever. So these are all the symptoms of hepatitis B. Let me see the transmission of hepatitis B, how it spread, how hepatitis B is spread. It is transmitted through various ways: mother to child, sexual contact, sharing of needles. Mother to child. It is transferred from infected mother to their babies. Pregnant women infected with HBV, that is hepatitis B virus, can pass the virus to their babies during childbirth. However, the newborn baby can be vaccinated to avoid getting infected in almost all cases. So this is one transmission method of hepatitis B. So next transmission method of hepatitis B is sexual contact. It is transmitted by unprotected sex with someone who is infected. The virus can pass through saliva, semen, vaginal secretion. Next method of transmission sharing of needles. Hepatitis B virus easily spreads through needles and syringes contaminated with infected blood. So see this picture, mode of transmission of HIV. Non-sterile tattooing needles, contaminated dialysis equipment, contaminated vaccination equipment, non-sterile dental practices, contaminated drug needles, non-sterile body piercing equipment. So through this way also HBV or hepatitis B virus transmitted. So it is also transmitted by contact with infected persons, secretion such as saliva, sweat, tears, breast milk and blood. So these are all the mode of transmission of hepatitis B virus. Let me see the prevention and control of hepatitis B. So what are all the preventive and control measures? Screening of blood donors before blood donation can prevent this transmission. Next, injection of drugs to be prevented. Having safe and protected sex also prevent this disease. Sharing of razors should be avoided. The hepatitis B vaccine offers excellent protection against hepatitis B virus. The vaccine is safe and highly effective. So, lead a healthy lifestyle, use a condom during sex, vaccination, follow the rules of personal hygiene, do not do piercings, tattoos in questionable places, observe the rules of anti-epidemic regime, avoid stress, use of sterile syringes. So these are all the prevention and control measures of hepatitis B. Next, let me pass on to the sexually transmitted disease caused by bacteria and viruses. So first, sexually transmitted disease caused by bacteria. It includes gonorrhea and syphilis. Let me see the causative organism, mode of transmission and symptoms. Gonorrhea. So gonorrhea is caused by a bacterium, Neisseria gonorrhea. Mode of transmission, sexual contact. The tissue organ affected, urethra is highly affected. Then symptoms of this particular disease, discharge from genital openings, pain during urination. Next type of bacterial disease, syphilis. The causative organism of syphilis is Treponema pallidum. Mode of transmission, through sexual contact. Tissue organ affected, minute abrasion on the skin or mucosa of genital area. Then symptoms, ulceration on genitals, skin eruption. So this is about bacterial disease, sexually transmitted bacterial disease, syphilis. Next, let me pass on to sexually transmitted disease caused by virus. It includes genital herpes and genital warts. Genital herpes, causative organism of genital herpes, herpes simplex virus. Mode of transmission, sexual contact, entry through mucous membrane of genital region. Tissue organ affected, genital organs of male and female individual. Symptoms, painful blisters in mouth, lips, face and genital region. So this is about genital herpes. Next, genital warts. It is also another sexually transmitted disease caused by virus. So the causative organism of genital warts is human papilloma virus, HPV. Mode of transmission, sexual contact. Tissue organ affected, genital areas of male and female individuals. Symptoms, vaginal discharge, itching, bleeding and burning. This is about genital warts. So far we discuss sexually transmitted disease caused by bacteria and virus. We discuss the symptoms, mode of transmission, prevention and control measures. That's all about today's class. Thank you.